Let us stand for prayer, please. Our Heavenly Father, we are here today to show our respects, our love for our good friend, Ralph. And Lord, we reflect on all those things that he meant to us. And Lord, we rejoice that we knew him as a friend. And Father, today as we honor him, we want to thank you for this privilege. And we want to thank you for everyone who has come. And Lord, we pray the service would be such that Ralph would be pleased. And Father, we ask this all in the name of thy Son, Jesus. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. I'd like to share some scripture with you. And pardon me, our scripture reading this morning is found in Psalms 90. And it's one verse. And it's reflective of Ralph's life, but not only Ralph's life, but each of us. He demonstrates to us this morning, with his presence here, that one day all of us will take that same journey. And it's inevitable. It's not a negative thing. It's just the way life happens. And yet we're taught in the Word of God to prepare for this day. And this is what Psalms 90 tells us. It is the oldest psalm in the Bible because it was written by Moses. And when we look at just this one verse that I want to share with you, after that, we will have special music from Tom Bishop. And first of all, let's consider this verse in Psalms 90 that I'd like to read for you. It's verse 12. Here is the request of Moses. He's asking God this request. Our request should be similar. He says, "So teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom." At this time, Brother Tom Bishop will favor us with a special.
Everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Jesus, still our refuge, thou wilt find us solace there. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there.
Appropriate that song is, as we think about Ralph, he had many friends, and of course that's reflective of all who came this morning, and many more who paid their respects during visitation. As we think about that song, what a friend we have in Jesus and Ralph, we think of the friend that he was to very, very many people. I had one gentleman tell me yesterday, he said, "I read the paper. I saw where Ralph passed away, and I thought his comment was appropriate." He said, "He was my jeweler." Not only him, but many other people. If we look at his obituary, you and I know, obituary is just a small picture of what a person was like. It tells us a little bit about who they're related to, a little bit about the history, which is fine. But we know that it doesn't tell everything about that person, and we understand that. It says, Ralph W. Reese, 88, of Abilene, passed away July 11, 2021, at Memorial Hospital in Abilene. He was born May 7, 1933, in Gypsum, Kansas, the son of Harry E. and Lucy Van Bruce Reese. Ralph enlisted in the United States Air Force, serving 4 years from 1953 to 1957. Ralph was a longtime Abilene businessman owning Reese Jewelry Store. He is survived by his sister, Yuletta Chautis, numerous nieces and nephews, and many good friends around the Abilene area. He was preceded in death by his parents, three brothers, Don Reese, Frank Reese, and Dale Reese, and one sister, Charlene McNary. And as we think about that obituary, as we said, it tells us a little bit about the person. You know much more about the person and the memories that you had of Ralph. And that's what we want to keep in mind as we would honor him today. This next song that Tom will share with us is a reflection on God. It's a reflection on the Lord Jesus Christ, but it's a hymn that many of you are familiar with. But it's a hymn by a writer whose life was not the best until he accepted Christ as his Savior. And so he wrote the song, Amazing Grace. And that song talks about how the Lord delivered him. And I think it's a wonderful hymn for this service because we want to be reminded of his amazing grace. Brother Tom, please.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Talks about verse 12 is we will all at some point come to where Ralph came to, and that is the cessation of life. And that doesn't have to be a negative thing. We know that life is fleeting. It's brief. We understand that. Ralph was 88. That's a long time. We realize that. But when we think about life, and we contrast that with the eternity or the eternality of God, that's a short period of time for us. we think about eternity. The emphasis in this portion of scripture really applies to all of us, okay? And what it tells us is, how do I use my time? Well, I think Ralph used his time wisely, and we'll say a little more about that in just a moment. But, pardon me, you know, usefulness always will surpass longevity. That's how we leave our mark in society. All of us will have a legacy. We will be remembered for something, and that's fine. And we hope that something is a benefit to others, as I think Ralph's legacy in part was. And I think it was his friendship to so many people. And that is an important thing. Now, Ralph knew one day he would close the door on that jewelry shop for the final time. Now, often he closed that jewelry store. Maybe it was go to get coffee, to have coffee with his friends. Maybe it was go to lunch. Or maybe it was to close that door for the end of the day's work. However, many of you like me, we would go to the jewelry shop and we'd see that little note on the door. Gone to coffee, wherever we're going. But you knew. But he'd come back, he'd be there. And so he always puts kind of the same note. I don't know if he kept the same note for all those years or not, but it sure seemed like it to me. But that, maybe he didn't, maybe he changed notes. And anyway, we knew that. But you know, he knew that one day he would close that door for the final time. But you know what? That doesn't have to be sad. That doesn't have to be negative. What do you mean? I want you to think with just for a moment. All the lives that Ralph touched, and there were many, yours, mine, as well. When I say he touched people's lives, it was not only with his conversation, with his fellowship, with his friendship, but it was often the advice that he gave. And, you know, he was very helpful to me, and I'll say a little more about that in just a moment, when I first came to Abilene. And I learned the benefit of gleaning from older people. Now, one time I was young, like many of you, but that changed. You know how that happens. But anyway, think about the lives that he touched. When we think about closing that door for the last time, and we will do it, you, me, you know what? Tomorrow or next week, you might read my obituary in the paper. That's just the way it is. We don't know. That's not a problem. But secondly, consider this, not only the lives that he touched, but how about the people that he encouraged? And he did do that. He did that with his fellowship. He did that with his humor. He did that with his conversation. And people just like to be around him, more than the fact that he had a jewelry store, because he encouraged people in his own way. And thirdly, think about this, the people that he helped. I want to illustrate it with this story. You probably saw me looking at my watch. I wasn't concerned about the time. You know the old joke when the preacher takes his watch off and he lays it on the pulpit. What it means, it doesn't mean anything. Don't pay attention to that. It's not going to happen. But I have this watch. When I first came to Abilene, and that's been a long time ago, we didn't have much. And so I needed a watch. Preacher needs to be on time. We all need to be on time. And so I went to see Ralph. And I talked to him. I said, here's the situation. I said, I need a watch. I need to be on time. And like I said, I didn't have much. And you know what? This was Ralph. Now, he didn't give me the watch, which I was appreciative of that. But he gave me a watch that I could afford. I still have that watch today. That's how much it means to me. I've taken good care of it. Well, the watch I had before was a self wind. I was constantly doing this. Well, I didn't pay attention when he sold me this watch. I put this nice watch on, and here I am. And it quit. I went to it back. I said, Ralph, this watch quit. And I've been self winding it. And He looked at me and said, Johnson, give me the watch. Yeah, he was. Give me that watch. I said, okay. He took the back off of it. He said, Johnson, don't you know this has a battery? To my chagrin, I said, no, I didn't know that battery. I can tell you one thing, I quit doing that. he was very helpful in that way. And, you know, later on, when things got a little better, we'd go in and jewelry store, and we'd do business, and he knew then things were a little better. But you know what? He still treated me, I think, in such a way that even if it cost a little extra, I was going to spend it in his store. That's the kind of person he was. But you'd go in his store, many of you did that. I like to look at the different cartoons. Now, I try to be very careful with political conversations. I won't say any more about that. But anyway, I'm very careful with political conversations. But one of the signs that I really liked, with the, I don't know if he still has it, but it said right there, in God we trust, all others must pay cash. I like that sign. But you know what that was? That was the impetus to share with him, as a pastor, the wonderful things about God and his son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he gave me opportunity. He was polite. Now, he was personal and private about his religious affiliation. And I didn't pry into that. I didn't push in that area. But you know what? He was always polite, and he let me present the gospel to him. I could tell him that God sent his son, his only son, into the world to die for your sin and my sin, that we could be saved from the penalty of sin. And what was interesting, each time I present the gospel to him or talk about some issue dealing with religion, he would always agree with me. And I thought, that's interesting. But he would always agree when I would present the gospel to him. And I thought that was very, very important, because that is the most important thing that we can think about. That's what our Psalms 90 is all about, that preparation. As we said, one day, you and I will be in the same situation. Our lives will be over. But I appreciated him talking to me and listening to me. When I get through, he'd always say this. Now, every time I went in the store, I didn't talk about religion, okay? We talked about other things, but when we had opportunity. And what was interesting, other people would come in. Ralph wouldn't say, Quiet Johnson, he wouldn't do that. And other people would listen, and they heard the gospel, and I thought that was so wonderful. He was just so polite to me, and I appreciated that so very, very much in him, that he would allow me to do that. But every time I would talk to him and share that with him, when I did, he'd always say, you're right. You're right. And I would leave it at that. He was a friend. You knew he was a friend. You knew him as a jeweler. And many of you had personal conversations with him. I think you were comfortable with him. He served this community well. When you talk about business people, giving to the community, Ralph is at the top of the list, because he did. And in many ways, not only with his jewelry shop, but the things that he involved himself in. To me, I think he was a model of what a business person should be like, serving other people. And I appreciate that so much about him. And I want to go back to this psalm, and then we'll close, okay? But let me read this verse to you again, if I could. And let's just think about this and see how this would apply to us. Remember the story of the watch that I told you about, that illustrated his life. In this psalm, in this verse 12, it illustrates something to us that is very important. And that is preparation. Preparation. I'm not getting involved in your personal life. That's not my point here this morning. My point here is to present to you a service that honors Ralph. And your presence honors Ralph. And we thank you for that. Not only does your presence honor him, but your participation in this service as well honors him. And I know he would be pleased with that. But as we look at this verse here, it is a personal challenge to you, to me. Are we prepared? This is inevitable. We know that. You know, I think I would be dilatory in my responsibility if I didn't share with you this great opportunity of the importance of preparation. The importance of preparation. And I think for all of us, we will spend eternity somewhere forever. Somewhere forever. And the most important aspect of that preparation is knowing that I'm going to spend eternity in heaven. Well, how can I know that? And many times as I told Ralph, I said, you know, you can know that by trusting Christ as your personal Savior. It's not a denominational thing. It's not a religious thing. It is a personal faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what the psalmist is talking about here in this verse. That we would be careful. We would number the days that we have. And we would live in such a way that we'd incline our hearts unto wisdom, making the right decisions with the life that God has given to us. For all of us, God has a definite purpose, and we can be thankful for that. We want to fulfill that purpose. And remember, the greatest part of that preparation is knowing Christ as your personal Savior. And that's the message that Ralph would allow me to share with him. And I appreciate that so much. As we said earlier, we talked about other subjects. And on occasion, we would talk about politics. And we had a balance there. And that's okay. And it's okay. But that was the kind of person that he was. To give himself to others in many, many ways. I'd be in his shop. Someone else would come in. It was obvious they were struggling. It was obvious they had a need. And they really couldn't meet that need because they didn't lack the resources. And I'd watch him work with people and how he would accommodate that situation so skillfully, but not as an enabler, but as someone who was trying to help. I always appreciated that about him. And I learned some great lessons about people, and it helped me tremendously in the ministry. I want to help people. You want to help people. But in such a way that we help them become self-sufficient. And that's the way Ralph was. He didn't give me that watch. He made me pay for that watch. And that was fine. I appreciated that. Otherwise, you know what? He may have been creating an enabler. I would go in there again and expect something. No, he didn't do it that way. And that speaks of character. But you know, that speaks of conviction and consciousness of the need of people. And that's the way Ralph was, and I appreciated that so very, very much. And maybe your experience is similar to that. I trust it is. And once again, we thank you for coming. We want to close our service here in a word of prayer, but I ask you to take this with you, and that is this. Remember those things about Ralph that encouraged you, that helped you, and how he helped so many people. He did that in a unique way, excuse me, and I always appreciated that. Let us pray. Our Father, we thank you. We thank you for the memory of Ralph. And Father, we thank you for his friendship. And Lord, we thank you for the lessons that we learned. And Lord, we thank you for the contribution that he made to this community. And he did. Lord, we want to see more people involved in our community as Ralph was. And Lord, that's what makes community better. Father, I believe Ralph did that. He helped make this community a better community. Lord, not because he had a jewelry shop that helped, but it was because of who he was and what he did. And we thank you once again for the friendship that we had with Ralph for so many years. And Lord, I'm sure many people here today feel the same way. And Father, thank you that we have such a good friend. And we ask this all in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we want to thank all of you for coming out. You know, the trip out here kind of reminds me of life. Sometimes it can be a long journey, but we made it. But the seating arrangement does the same. It's kind of like a church to try to get people to sit in the front row. It's next to a miracle. But we want to thank all of you for coming out to the graveside service and for the committal service that we're going to have here in just a moment. And I was listening to some of the gentlemen, pallbearers, speak, and it was really encouraging in some of the things they wanted to do. And one of the things that was mentioned was putting the coffee cup in the casket with Ralph. But they forgot that, but they did get his cap. But you know what that speaks of? That speaks of a personal connection with a friend. And it means so much. It might just be a little thing, but it means so much. It speaks volumes when you do small things like that. And I thought that is so appropriate. And that's how we remember people, how we identify with people. And I thought that's encouraging. The scripture I want to share with you is a familiar portion of scripture. And it is read at most funeral services, at the graveside service, but it's so appropriate. And it talks about the resurrection. And that one day, we will, all of us, when we die, we will be resurrected. The Bible tells us that very clearly. But the encouraging thing about the resurrection is it talks about the victory that we really have over death. And that's important for all of us. We all look for that final victory. And sometimes we don't realize this is when it comes, when this life is over. And we look at this portion of scripture, and I'll just read a few verses, and we'll have a prayer of committal. And we encourage you to stay in fellowship and just reminisce with others about Ralph, his life, and what he meant to you. And I trust that would be an encouragement to you. But in 1 Corinthians 15, beginning in verse 51, he said, "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trump shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruption must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain." And all that Ralph did over the years was not in vain, because it impacted many lives, and that makes a life worth living. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we do commit Ralph's body to the earth from whence it came, as the Bible tells us, from ashes to ashes, to dust to dust. Lord, we commit his soul unto thee and to thy keeping. Thou art a just God, and Lord, we know the judge of all the earth shall do right. Father, we thank you for all who have come, and we thank you once again for the privilege we have of knowing Ralph, being his friend, and being encouraged by him in so many different ways. As we conclude this service, we thank you once again for your love to us. And we ask this all in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you for coming.